Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Paul's Cathedral, and welcome to those of you watching us online this evening. Reminder that we are open for live audiences every week now, every Thursday at 5:30. So please do come and give us a listen live if you're in the area and can do so. Tonight on the program, we have some Bach, the Fantasia in G major to open. And then the second half of the program is British music of different periods. We've got some Wesley for you, a really beautiful little pastoral, and a couple of pieces that are really favorites of mine by Percy Whitlock, who's sort of kind of fallen off recital programs, I think, too much. It's really interesting stuff. I'll tell you a little bit more about it later. The Bach is one of my favorites to play, and one of my favorite things about this particular organ and all its versatility, as this allowed me this time to open up the piece and entirely re-register it and recreate it from the last time I played it. This time I've set it up somewhat along the lines of a very kind of robust two-manual tracker organ of some of the resources that would have been had approximately in the Baroque era. Another thing about this organ, like all good cathedral organs, it can be something of a chameleon. We can make it sound, you know, like a nice clean kind of Baroque sound, this nice French sound, the English Romantic, the American Classic. It does it all, and does it all so well. So for those of you who like to pay attention to this kind of thing, in the Bach, the plenum is based this time really on the choruses of the swell and the choir division, and not so much of the great, which is really, really broad on this particular organ, much more so than those of his time. So please enjoy. I'll start with the Bach's Fantasia in G, and then I'll talk a little bit more about the Whitlock in a few minutes. Thank you. it gives me a chance to highlight several of my favorite stops on the organ, and I'll tell you a little bit about the history of each one. The first one you're going to hear stating the theme the first time is the Choir 8-Foot Principal. That's one of our newer stops. It was built by Quimby during our rebuild about 5 years ago, so that's one of our brand new stops. The second entry is the Great 8 and 4 foot Flutes, which are both from the original Aeolian Skinner organ from 1969 installation here. And the third, or the echo part, is the 8 foot flute, the chimney flute of the Swell Division, which is originally dates back to the 1950 Moeller organ that was here when we first moved into this building. Moeller was the company that moved the organ and brought the original Hook and Hastings in and put a new console in. So there's little historical tidbits and things that we'll hear in this piece. Really charming, melodic little piece, as I said. And then we move into the two pieces by Whitlock. I'm playing two of the four extemporizations for organ for you tonight. The first piece is number 3, titled Fidelis, or Faithful. What do I say here? How do I describe this? So his sensibility really, even though he's in the 20th century, I think really continues that wonderful, rich tradition of especially the 19th century English style of just excess to the most ridiculous degree in registrations and thickness and harmonies and everything. Even in this lighter piece, the first one, there's so much doubling and wonderful, you know, rich, lush harmonies, a little bit of jazz stuff thrown in here, wonderful solo registrations, and immediately launches into the fanfare, number 4, which is written in 7/8 meter, which is odd for a fanfare. It's a little bit like if we were walking out, kind of tripping down the aisle here with that missing eighth pulse of each bar. And again, excess, using the full Swell Division all over the place, both big solo reeds, the solo tromba, the solo tuba mirabilis, all get great showings on this. Everything from that on down to the solo clarinet and strings and the whole thing. So within the context of these pieces, he shows us pretty much everything he can do, everything an organ like this can do. They're really wonderful pieces. I hope personally to see them on more recitals and recordings and things coming up again. So we'll start with Wesley and then the two pieces by Percy Whitlock. Thank you again for being here this evening, and hope to see you again next week.